Your Majesty, Your Royal Highnesses, President of the International Olympic Committee, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Today sees the closing of a wonderful Games in a wonderful city. We lit the flame and we lit up the world. For the third time in its history, London was granted the trust of the Olympic movement. And once again, we have shown ourselves worthy of that trust. And for that, I want to say thank you. Thank you to the people who built the stadiums, the people who created a new neighborhood in an old city, the people who stood guard to keep us safe. Thank you to the London organizing team, to every one of you who has worked so hard and who turned the buildings into a theatre of sport and drama and choreographed these games, and to the International Olympic Committee, which has been with us every step of the way. Thank you to the tens of thousands of volunteers Volunteers who gave their time, their boundless enthusiasm, and their goodwill, and who have the right to say tonight, I made London 2012. And thank you to the people of this country. The British people got behind London's bid, and they got behind London's Games. Our opening ceremony proclaimed that these would be a Games for everyone. At our closing ceremony, we can say that these were a Games by everyone. London 2012 has played host to some incredible sport, to awe-inspiring feats that are the synthesis of incredible dedication and skill by the world's great sportsmen and women. To all the Olympians who came to London to compete, thank you. Those of us who came to watch witness moments of heroism and heartbreak that will live long in the memory. You have our admiration and our congratulations. This may be the end of these two glorious weeks in London, but what we have begun will not stop now. The spirit of these Olympics will inspire a generation. We have seen in these days what tenacity can do, what ambition can do, what imagination can do. We know more now, as individuals and as a nation, just what we are capable of. And that knowledge will drive us on. On the first day of these games, I said we were determined to do it right. I said that these games would see the best of us. On the last day, I can finish with these words. When our time came, Britain, we did it right. Thank you.
A powerful speech at the opening and a powerful speech at the conclusion. And a message which needs to be made true. Ordered by Prince Harry.
It now gives me very great pleasure
and the Duchess of Cambridge there
to introduce the President of the International Olympic Committee, Dr. Jacques Rogge.
Your Majesties, Your Royal Highnesses, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, after 17 unforgettable days, we are indebted to so many tonight. The organizing committee, well supported by the public authorities, did a superb job. Thank you, Lord Coe, and your great Locock team. We will never forget the smiles, the kindness and the support of the wonderful volunteers, the much-needed heroes of these games. You, the spectators and the public, provided the soundtrack for these games. Your enthusiastic cheers energized its competitors and brought a festive spirit to every Olympic venue. You have shown the world the best of British hospitality. I know that generosity of spirit will continue as we marvel at the dedication and talent of the wonderful Paralympic athletes. Dear athletes, you have earned the respect and admiration of a global audience, and you have written a new chapter of Olympic history that began in ancient Olympia 3,000 years ago. Through your commitment to fair play, your respect for opponents, and your grace in defeat as well as in victory, you have earned the right to be called Olympians. These were happy and glorious games. L'héritage des Jeux de la 30e Olympiade apparaîtra clairement sous de multiples formes. La nation hôte bénéficiera pendant des années à venir des améliorations concrètes apportée à l'infrastructure. Chaque contrée du monde aura sa part de l'héritage humain. De nombreux jeunes seront motivés à se lancer dans la pratique d'un sport ou à poursuivre leurs rêves. And now, in accordance with tradition, I declare the Games of the 30th Olympiad closed and call on the youth of the world to assemble 4 years from now in Rio de Janeiro to celebrate the Games of the 31st Olympiad. Thank you, London.
Very appreciative speech by the President of the IOC.